Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to another week of Worship Plus Music Theory. This week, instead of getting bogged down in just theoretical ideas, I want to talk about a practical use from something that we talked about in the last episode, which was where do chords come from? It's not just that, you know, some notes fall in love and get married and have chord babies. We talked about what that is last week. If you want to know more about that, make sure that you watch that video. It's very, very important to understanding where we're going to go today. So go back and click that and watch that video if you haven't already seen it. And let's get into how to be creative with chords now that we know where chords come from. Now, here's the definition that I like to use for what chords are in music. And remember, music is a language. And just like I'm talking to you in English right now, it's not just the words that I'm saying, it's the way that I'm saying it. Notice when I'm talking to you, I know that you can understand it. I'm confident that you're getting this concept, and that way that I'm communicating is as important as the words that I'm actually using. And here's the way that I want you to think of music. The individual notes in a song, let's say our melody, let's say we sang, you are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. That's a melody line. Those are individual words. Melody lines are to music what individual words are to language. So I have my melody line. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. And then the chords that I decide to play over it. And they can be different chords. And that's what we're going to talk about today. The chords that I play over the top and the speed, the rhythm that I play it at, and the strum pattern that I pick on guitar, and whether it's fast or whether it's slow or fingerpicked, all of those different things. But today, specifically, what chords I pick is how I'm saying the song. So if I play all major chords, let's take You Are My Sunshine. Here's a G chord.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray.
Now, those are all major chords, and it's kind of a happy sound. But if you go check out You Are My Sunshine by the Civil Wars, what you'll find is that they picked all minor chords.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray.
Same strum pattern.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine.
Now, when I pick different chords, my melody does want to move a little bit. I will grant you that. But even if you play the exact melody or sing the exact same melody, these minor options completely change the feeling of where that song is going. And that's what chords do. Depending on the chord that you pick, it changes how you're saying your words, your melody line. Now, let's check out what the best options are and the easiest options to get started writing your own songs and being creative in your own lyrics and in your own music is.
All right, so when it comes to harmonizing the major scale, it's easiest to see that on the piano, which I have here in front of me. And so let's take a look at what our chord options are so we can decide where to put those chords. All right, number one. This is a C major scale. We're going to start on the note C here. This is middle C. And we're going to play up every white note. That is the C major scale. Now, last week in Where Chords Come From, we talked about the fact that chords are made by playing every other note in the scale. So there's our C major chord. Now to quickly harmonize it, the C major scale is only white keys. So our chords would be this, C. Our second chord is D minor. Our third chord is E minor. fourth chord is F, fifth chord is G, or sixth chord is A minor, seventh chord is B diminished. Nobody uses that one much. And then if I go one more, I'm just back to where I started on another C chord. Now, remember, music theory is just that. It is a theory. It's an approach to understanding something complex. It is not music law. So I'm going to show you a music theory, a way among many to approach songwriting. And here's what I want you to remember. The C chord feels like home. Let's call it the one chord. So in our theory, we are going to number our chords 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And for our theory, we're going to look at it this way. 1 is home. And the further up I go, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the more away it feels. So check this out. Let's do the same song that we did before. Here's C. This is my one chord. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. And that feels at home. But if I play the sixth chord, you are my sunshine, my only sunshine. That chord is further away from home, and consequently, it feels sad. Because home is the place that everything feels comfortable, right? Home is where you can relax, you can take a deep breath. At the end of your day, you pull into the driveway, you walk in your door, and you feel at home. Your bed is at home for you, and no place feels like home. It's fun to go away, but nothing feels as good as coming home. And that's the theory that we're going to use today. So let's take this into account. Let's write a song that's actually about home, right? Maybe what we'll do is we'll play A minor, 6, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then let's just go home. Let's play 6, let's play 4, and then we're gonna go down to 1. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. Now, you make me happy. That doesn't feel at home yet. If I go to 1, it's gonna feel at home. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy. Kind of feels funny. So let's keep it up. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. And let's let that go home. Maybe I'll hit some C's on the left hand too. So I could play this chord an octave lower. Here's A minor again. You are my sunshine. Right? Maybe we'll sing it a little higher and play a little lower. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. Now, as long as I just go 6 and 4, right, A minor and F, it's always going to feel a little lonesome. What's happening? That is 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? This is C. Anytime there's two black keys, this is C. It doesn't matter if I play it here or if I play it here or here. Wherever I play, that's A no matter what. This is C no matter what. So I'm going to play my 6 chord, which is A. I'm going to play my 4 chord, which is F, A minor to be exact. But check this out. As long as I just go 6, 4, 6, 4, 6, 4, I'm always going to feel away. It's never going to feel at home. Oh, I just want to go home. Haven't been home in far too long. Now I'm there. That's how people write songs. They know one feels like home. They know that everything else, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, feels further away. And one feels like it comes home again. And that's good storytelling. In a good story, here's what happens. Everything's good. We have a baseline. Everything's fine. And then something bad happens. Somebody comes and kills your dog, like John Wick. And now we're not home anymore. Home's been messed up, and now we have to go on this journey, and that is what makes an interesting story. Let me tell you the least interesting story that has ever been written in human history. Once upon a time, they lived happily ever after. Nobody cares. Good stories have tension, and tension needs to move away. And then ultimately, if you want a fairy tale ending, you have to arrive back at home. If you want a Greek tragedy, never go home. And that's up to you, because this is about your creativity. But in order to be creative, you have to know what these chords make people feel. Music is ultimately there to make people feel. If you're watching a movie, you can tell when people are happy, when people are sad, when they're about to fight, when there's tension, when there's peace, all by just listening to the soundtrack. A lot of the time, there's not even dialogue from the actors. You can feel what you're supposed to feel by just listening to the music. And the music doesn't need words to do that. It needs harmony. It needs chords. And then you need a theory of harmony to allow you to be creative. And here's your theory. Every chord is numbered 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And the further away from 1 you get, the more tension the chord has. So that's how you get creative. Now, one more thing, speaking of tension. I mentioned earlier that the 7th chord, that's what's called diminished. Now, diminished chords don't get used that often, just like back in the day in silent movies. We'll just stay with the movie analogy since we're already here and we've been saying it all this entire video. Back in the day in a silent movie, you would have people overact, right? Even up into the 70s, I love the old Star Trek. All of those old TV shows, everybody reacted in a huge way because they were on a tiny TV and they didn't have the technology that we have now. They didn't tell stories through visuals the way that we do. So everybody overacted because they were still acting like they were in a theater, right? So something would happen and the actor's like, It was too much. And also in the music of that time, they would go to 7 a lot. Now think about it. If 1 is at home, 7 is as far away as we can get. And so you're not going to hear that 7 chord very often. And what I'm telling you, and the reason I'm bringing it up, is in your own creativity, use that 7 chord very sparsely. I would say 1 out of every 100 modern songs has a diminished chord in it. And the reason for that is very, very simple. It's too dramatic. A diminished chord sounds like Colonel Mustard just got murdered in the library with a wrench. No! That sound is too over the top. So what do we have then? You have 6 options to write a great song. Most songs are 4 chords or less. And now you have a theory to write your own. Now go practice.